In addition to writing and directing, you're also a musician now. Now, this is a new thing.
Sort of, yeah. I mean, I'm barely a musician.
Yeah, but well, explain this to me.
All right, so, you know, I always wanted to play guitar, always had a guitar, tried to teach myself, could never do it. I tell my wife this, and then for my 35th birthday, a long time ago, she gets me a guitar and lessons. And I fully commit to it, so that's 12 years ago, so I decide, every day I'm going to practice. And a couple of years later, I'm jamming with a buddy of mine from high school and the guy that does the music for my films, and we kind of stumble upon a song. And this guy, P.T. Walkley, does the music. He's like, hey, you know, I think there's a pretty good song here. Let's flesh it out. So he comes back, you know, 2 days later, he's written lyrics for it, and we play it. And I'm like, let's just record it. I was doing a movie at the time. I said, we'll record it, and I'll sneak it into the film onto the soundtrack. So,
That's what friends are for. Ed Burns, yeah, I wrote, starred in it. Yeah, I can add this thing. I think I can pull some strings, yeah.
So we do that, and we come up with a name for the band. You know, our mascot for our high school was the Blue Jackets, so we called the band the Blue Jackets, and we put it on the soundtrack.
This is fantastic.
Yeah, so then we're like, all right, let's play a couple of gigs. So you know the Hamptons. There's a place called the Talk House out in Amagansett.
Oh, yeah, seems tough.
So every summer we would play, you know, 3 or 4 gigs there. And that was the thing. So we're doing this for a couple of years.
But here's where it gets...
It gets a little weird.
It gets fun to be you, because you're you. You play these gigs, you're out in the Hamptons, you play these bars, and there's someone that comes to see you at one of these gigs who just happens to be in the crowd.
Yeah.
Yeah, and that person is Chris Martin from Coldplay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So...
It's just the way his life is. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, yeah. You would never see my band in a bar. Yeah. And here's where it gets insanely awesome.
So he comes to my 40th birthday party, and he goes, look, you know, I didn't know what to get you, so I was thinking this. We're doing a free concert at the Garden, and do you think the Blue Jackets would want to open for us?
I mean...
Yeah.
So you say no.
So you say no, I can't make it that day.
So you open for... You played Madison Square Garden?
For about 4 months, I don't do anything other than... You know, I'm not a... You know, I play a bar band rhythm guitar.
Yeah, absolutely.
He gives us 25 minutes, 5 songs. So then we turn into a real band. Like, every day we're rehearsing for those 5 songs.
Oh, my God.
And talk about nervous. I mean, never in my entire life. Like, I still have those memories of, like, the middle of the first song, like... having to turn around and, like, adjust my amp, and literally my hand is
shaking. And where's your wife? Can you see her in the crowd?
I can't see her, because, you know, I mean, you can't see anything, because the lights are on stage.
No, we don't know. None of us have played Madison Square Garden. We don't play Madison Square Garden.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
I have one memory of just being able to, like, look and just, like, seeing a silhouette of people, like, watching from the... whatever you call it, the hallway.
Yeah.
And they're actually paying attention. You know, we're the opening act for Coldplay.
You're assuming.
And there were some folks that were actually listening to us.
You're assuming everyone's just going to the bathroom. Yeah. Let's get a couple of beers.
Everyone's at the bar getting loaded up, you know. Which maybe helped their enjoyment of us.
That's such a good move.
That was fun.
I love that.